Good morning, survivors. Happy Thursday, or happy whatever day you happen to be watching this video on. I just want to say, I've had a wonderful morning here. I got up, sun was shining bright, decided to make myself some delicious coffee, and that brings me here to an excellent story, actually. A story that I find funny, and I think you guys might find funny as well here, too. Last episode, we ended the episode... Oh, shit. Like, look at all these zombies. Okay. Doing this exact same crap. You know, I'm actually just gonna ignore them this time, because we have some stuff to do. I have to go do stuff and things. But anyways, we ended the last episode on this jail here, on top one of the towers. If I go back up, I should actually... Do I have any food in the... I'll come back here later to find out. Oh, I have no water. Oh, damn. Okay. I do need to go up there. We need to go and re... Hate it when I do that. Anyways, we need to go back up there and find some food and drink, because I think that's where I stored it all. Apparently, I don't have any empty glasses, and my thirst is zero, so let's go get this taken care of here. So what happened was, it was, what time was it? It was about 4 a.m. in-game, or 3:50 or something like that. It was real close to morning time, right? And I'm over doing my dishes, AFK. Just kind of waiting for the night to go through. I don't like changing the options to make the night run faster. Personally, I love my survival playthroughs, and I don't believe that's playing that is actually playing the game legitimately. Oh shit! I have 7 yucca juice right here. Okay, I'm gonna drink that. But I don't think that's playing the game legitimately. So what I do on most overnights when I'm recording is I just AFK or I do my other overnight stuff that I need to do. Because I don't have a permabase yet, and it's not very useful, so... this zombie fell down here, that's funny. So, what I was doing is, because I'm a couch gamer, I game on my couch ever since I switched to console gaming. Where are those guys? I can hear them all. Oh, they're all in the tower now. Stay there. When I switched to console gaming, I got used to couch gaming, right? Like, my TV actually sits on my computer desk. I should buy myself a TV stand. I couldn't put it on the wall here where I live right now, but I'll have my own house here soon, so that'll change. But anyways, I'm couch gaming, right? So I start up the game, make sure everything's safe, and I'm like, well, I'll go do my dishes and everything while I'm waiting for the night cycle to end. So I'm like, okay, whatever, you know, all's happy and fun. And I get over and I'm doing my dishes, right? And I'm crouched and I'm looking down at the edge and watching like 5 or 6 zombies run around in circles, piling on top of each other. They just couldn't figure out how to get to me on the night cycle, so I was kind of laughing at it, right? And this morning, I decided, you know what? My dog stinks. I'm gonna do his bedding. I'm gonna wash his bedding. I'm gonna wash him. So I took his bedding away. I threw it in the washer, and I came back, right? And I'm still doing dishes a bit, and I hear my dog, woof, woof, woof. Now you have to understand. My dog's like 18 years old. He has a very hard time doing things, like anything. Even getting up, he has a hard time doing. So I look over, right? I'm like, what the heck is he doing? Oh, that's cool. I just got something about Boundless on my Steam overlay. I've never seen that before. But I look over, right? And he's trying to get up on the couch. And I'm like, aw. He's not allowed up on the couch. But you may as well give her a try, buddy, right? I'm completely ignoring it. Completely forgetting the fact that I'm a couch gamer. And I have a mouse and keyboard on my couch. So he finally gets up there, right? So I'm like, I'm not even gonna give him shit. I mean, he hasn't tried that in like a year, whatever, right? Like, I took his blanket away, so he's all pissy right now. I'll let him chill out on the couch. I look over, and what do I see my character do? Stand up, walk off the edge, and literally go right straight towards a group of zombies running at him. And that was what she wrote. So that is my first death on a single player playthrough. My dog. My dog freaking killed me. Good job, though, buddy. I wasn't even mad at him. I was just like, oh my god. I should have known better. I should have put the keyboard and mouse up when I seen him trying to do that. Okay, do we have any friends? We have some friends here. So this is where I really want to build my base. I want to build it on top of this this peak here. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to make a little storage area for myself, because I have no storage. I'm pretty much carrying around whatever's in my inventory right now, and it's not very convenient. And also, too, the last episode, I was getting headshots. Like, you guys confirmed it. I was getting headshots, and I went back and rewatched it myself, too. But for some reason, the arrows were going right through them, which was kind of weird. But I hope that's something they fixed. Another thing I noticed as well, too, is I had a bloated walker. I had a bloated walker following me. And I was like, oh, okay, whatever, right? And I was kind of, I was getting ready to shoot an arrow at him. And what did the bloated walker do? Fell over dead by itself. I didn't even have to kill it. I was able to loot it and everything. But for some reason, the walker died. Just out of the blue. Just keeled over, and that was it. So I don't know what that was about. That was a little odd, too. Have you guys come across anything like that? Like, I've heard about players dying randomly for no reason. But I'm not admitting smell, am I? No. But to have a zombie die like that, this is the first time I've ever come across anything or even heard that. Once again, I really do wish I had that death on film, because that would have been amazing. You guys would have just heard me yelling across the room, oh my god! Oh, fuck. Because that's exactly how that sounded like. Oh, my poor dog. Love him to death, though. Love him to death. He earned it, so I let him stay up there. Okay, cool. There's a little shed over there. I'm not going to put it at the shed because that's a POI and it'll constantly spawn things in. So what I'm going to do is I'm not going to worry about building or anything here yet. I'm going to get this this chest down and then we'll go from there. Okay, where is storage chest? Here you are. A secure storage chest just in case nobody wants to break into it. That's the one thing that's really nice about single player is you don't have to worry about people fucking with your shit. That is a one bonus, I must admit. Okay, ammo. I have too much fruit. I have a candle. Oh, I had a candle on me. The one thing, though, is I did lay... Ooh, bedroll. I'm going to put the bedroll up here, too. I didn't lay a bedroll down, so when I died, what had happened was I ended up all the way at my other bedroll, and I had to come all the way back. Now, I found it kind of funny. It didn't really piss me off that much. But on the way back, what I did, because I had to make a few phone calls, so I was like, you know what, I'm going to make a few phone calls while I'm doing this, get everything done here at once. So I made a few phone calls, and on the way back, what I did was I started making some stone axes. I would stop and hit stone while I was talking on the phone, make some more stone axes, scrap them. So I did get my skills up a bit here. It actually looks like my axe is getting a little depleted, so I'm going to make a new one. Now, I do like the new balance where you don't really have to do like major scrap. What do you call it? What should I call it? Major scrapping, I guess? Like, mass crafting, that's what it is. Mass crafting. You don't have to do mass crafting. What I like to do is I like to use the first few levels for my tools. I get them to about 150 quality, and from there I just start pumping points into it because it starts to really slow down at that point. So, I mean, he didn't really nerf mass crafting, he just made it harder. So now what I do is I always go and scrap the stone axes I get from doing that to get the stone back, because it takes more materials now to do all that stuff. Oh, this yucca juice is going to be invaluable in this biome. I got a feeling I got to plant a huge garden because I'll be picking all the materials out of this area. Sweet, back up to 90 for for health and stamina. Oh, that sucked. I couldn't believe I looked over and see my character walking off the top. I was just like, no. But yeah, at least I got some time here to go back and actually get some stuff done. Because that night cycle, I pretty much just stood there and stared at the zombies. So it wasn't like I was doing much. Cool. Yeah, lots of yucca. Lots and lots of yucca. I also need to look for a nest here. Oh, that's a stone. That's not a nest. Jeez. Good morning, Skippy. So, yeah, I made phone calls, had some coffee, got my materials up, did some grinding, got back to where my purse, my backpack was, and then called it a day. 103 degrees Fahrenheit. I thought I drank some yucca. I guess it doesn't cool you down as much as it used to. I'm going to have to check that out. But I can make clothing and stuff to cool myself off. That's not a big problem. Now, let's see what we got here. This plant fiber, I know I already made this here. I want to go to crafting. Why did I go to skills looking for plant fiber? Plant fiber, here we go. I think that cools you off. Ah, yes. Okay, so I'm going to make a hat here as well, too, and put the hat on, because it seems like I'm going to be having an overheating problem here. Especially doing a lot of grinding in a desert as well, too. That'll bring up my heat. But, like I said, I rather overheat than freeze. Both in real life and in game. So now it's just a bunch of looting. Basically getting my scavenging skills up, finding supplies, getting everything together. I don't even know what my skills are at, actually. Next episode here. Next episode I record, I should have a customized GUI up on my screen. And you guys are probably like, what is GUI? That sounds like a funny word. For those who don't know what it is, GUI is a graphical user interface. And what that means is my toolbar, my health, my stamina, my quest, my compass, everything you see on my screen that you can interact with, that's your GUI. So basically what I've done on the server is I've put in an improved GUI. Why is that not cooling me down at all? Let's wear that hat. See if that makes a difference. Maybe find some clothing here too, because like shirts and stuff will cool you down. Shorts cool you down, so we'll get some shorts going as well too. Shit, 109? You gotta be kidding me. Today must be a very hot day. Maybe that's what it is. It's just a hot day. Whoops. My god. I have been playing a lot on a multiplayer server, and you tend to forget how many zombies can actually spawn in. Because on multiplayer, zombie spawns are shared, right? Like, you don't get this amount on multiplayer. Because you have to split up a certain amount of zombies between X amount of players, right? So, I do have to say, multiplayer survival is easier in that aspect because you don't have the amount of zombies to deal with. Okay, do I have any coming from behind me here? I'm still hot. But it doesn't look like I'm heating up anymore. Take everything these guys got. Whoops. Right in the face. Right in the kisser. Okay, holy crap, they're still coming. I got the whole city here. This was like yesterday when I guided that whole mob around in circles. Oh my goodness, that was a lot of zombies. But it's a good way to clear the zombies out of the immediate area if you don't have the ammo or you just don't feel like taking them on at the moment. Okay, cool. Well, that was a bunch of loot. Oh, and the coolest thing too about the GUI, guys, is that you can actually see your XP shit. What am I stuck on? Oh, I got stuck on those zombie remains? You gotta be kidding me. Okay, I should take some health here. This is getting bad. There we go. I'll use a pill. Finally, I got something for health. That'll work. Oh, and now apparently I'm thirsty again. Okay, cool. Okay, so I'm slowly cooling back off now. That's good. That's good. That's where I want to be. I don't want to be overheating. Because I really, like, honestly, a lot of people really like the clubs. But I prefer the sledgehammer. I'm a sledgehammer guy myself. Cool stuff to make a forge with. Awesome. We'll get a forge going almost right away, too. What I'll do is I'll keep a forge house for now. Maybe, like, make this house a forge house. I really don't care if it gets trashed. Where'd that chicken go? Where you at, chicken? I saw you, like, literally a second ago. Sneaky little bastard. Okay. So let's break into this house here. I'll loot it, and then this will turn into our forge house. Because it's nice and close to the base, and it's only going to be one forge until I dig myself some sort of underground complex that I can get into. Hit up all these seats for cloth and wood. I love how dark it is in here. Now, they did the same thing with console, where they changed the lighting so that it was, like, super dark like this. And, oh my god, did they ever get backlash on console. They changed it quite quickly. It lasted one patch, I think. I think it's gorgeous. I think it makes sense. Who the fuck cares if it's bright as hell out outside? If I go into the house with no fucking lights on, it's gonna look like this. This is what it's gonna look like. It's gonna be dark as fuck, alright? So you guys are gonna have to deal with that. Bring a torch. Bring a headlamp. Do something. But this is what stuff should look like. I like it. That's a little bit of a rant I had. I've always had that little bit of rant. I hated when they changed it back on console. Like, it literally looks like Unicorn Happy Land. Like, it's so incredibly bright and easy to see absolutely everything. It's almost immersion breaking, in my opinion. That's what it is to me. It's immersion breaking. It's not friggin' Minecraft. If I wanted to play Minecraft, I'd be playing Minecraft. It's easy to see shit in Minecraft. But this is a zombie apocalypse with real houses. You're not coming across some magical fantasy land that doesn't exist anywhere else. Okay. Definitely eat these up. So I got some foods and some hungers going on. Awesome. Oh, nice. This one has a basement, too. I'm definitely throwing the forge in the basement here. Oh, mushroom seeds. I'll take those. I'll pretty much take everything at this moment. I'll take poop. Nice, poop. And two, for those who haven't been using Alpha 15, bottled murky water and empty bottles now, the glass jars, stacked to 500 on vanilla. So it's actually worth it now to grab all those glass jars when you're out looting, because they only take up one slot, but yet stack up to so many. So, okay, bathroom, okay, already got it. Now we need to go upstairs. Oh, and curtains are also a decent source of cloth as well, too. Okay. Let's go in this way, since there'll be less breaking. Oh, I really wish I had a headlamp right now. I feel so old school. Okay, what's this room got? Give me something good here. Football helmet and paper. That's okay. With a football helmet, I can make a headlamp. So I'll hold on to that one football helmet I have right now. Okay. Let's pick this torch back up here. Whoops. There we go. What else is up here? I gotta hit up the rooms, because the rooms are the ones that have furniture in them. And I need to find myself some clothing to stop from overheating as well. Okay, nothing in this room. Let's go see the attic here. Let's go see what goodies the attic might have for us. Oh, and I also noticed something weird too, because I did hit the roof. Remember how you guys always said, you know, I'm going to spend some time smashing this roof in because it's made out of wood if I'm going to be up here and bored. Well, I did that, and I noticed if you hit something that's on a slope, the animation for the parts, you see how these little parts come flying from it, right? Like that, they just come flying. Oh, wait, you know what? It kind of does it on the flat stuff, too. If you look at it, it's really goofy. They kind of sit on top, but if you do it on the sloped one, they actually move. They hover above the block, and they move down. So they really got to fix those animations. It looks really funky. Just try it yourselves, guys. Oh, wait, you know what? Actually, let's see if it does it on the underside of these. Yeah, no, it doesn't do it to the underside. They actually fall straight down. But if you're on the top half of that block, it'll actually do some funky stuff for the, I guess you can call those sprites. We'll call them sprites for all intents and purposes. Okay. Torch. Awesome. Wow, there is like shit all in this house. But it'll make a good forge house because it has that sweet, sweet basement. I'm going to put the forge down there. Leave it running for days. Look at this. I didn't even search this nightstand. Okay, so that will warm me up. I actually don't need that. I really wish you could scrap these. Like, why can you not scrap these things? They should scrap into leather. Okay, cool. Next. Holy shit. It's almost nighttime again. I'm going to have to spend the night up in one of these houses, I think. Look for another safe house for the night. Because I'm definitely not going to spend the night standing beside my storage area. That wouldn't be very smart now, would it? And I think I have, like, all my supplies with me so I can build stuff. Yes, I do. That is exciting. Awesome. And I can't wait to get to my first Horde Knight. Now, they've completely changed. Whoops. They've completely changed how Hordes work on Horde Knight. They're scalable, which means by your difficulty the last time you died. And you actually only get max 8 zombies at a time. So it's really important to dispatch those zombies if you want more zombies. The quicker you do it, the faster it's going to happen. Can I hit this guy when he's doing this? Like this? Right in the face? Oh, I can. Nice. Suck it, crawler. So, the first Horde Knight's actually incredibly freaking easy. All you have to do on your first Horde Knight, if you're not ready, if you don't have anything prepared, all you have to do is go into the top of, like, a store or a building and just hang out up there. Just make sure they can't get up to the top where you are. Or if they can, just take out the ones that do. And you have a safe Horde Knight. Like, literally, all you get is, like, maybe 8 zombies and a few that were in the general area and heard the commotion. And they'll just smash around at night. Now, from what I've heard from Joel, he plans on changing that. Because people are like, well, it's stupid you only get 8 zombies. That makes for a really shitty Horde Knight, right? That's more for multiplayer, in my opinion. Like, they... 2018, okay. So, with multiplayer, everyone gets a Horde Knight on Horde Knight now. It used to be before where you'd only get... I'm going to aim for, actually, that brick building over there. It used to be before... you'd only get, only one person would get the Horde Knight. So everyone on the server, if you know, you'd have to be friends with them or whatever, would have to go to their base and hopefully get a chunk of the action. But at least now everyone gets a little bit of the action. Not one person getting a lot of it, everyone's getting a little. Now that's why I've built a community Horde Knight area on my server where everyone goes to at Horde Knight. So we end up just getting one giant max insane Horde Knight. If you guys have managed to catch any of my, or haven't managed to catch any of my live streams, definitely try to catch those guys. If you have not yet, to get the notifications on when I upload a video or I go live, go to my subscribe button, look beside it, and beside that subscribe button, I'm gonna make this axe here, and beside that subscribe button should be a little bell. Now they have changed it so that you don't automatically get notified of videos and stuff now when you subscribe. What you have to do is you have to click on that bell to tell YouTube that you want to know when that person is subscribing. Now that's another wonderful change that YouTube didn't tell his content creators about. And I've noticed a drop in my videos since it's been implemented because people, you know, they don't know. They don't know the video's out, right? Like it'll show up in your feed and stuff. But those people like me who have a few content creators that we really enjoy, we subscribe to those guys and then just kind of leave the rest, right? We go to our newsfeed if we want to see the rest. Oh, shit. Oh, get off me. Get off me. I'm going to try to actually navigate these guys away from my base because it's like 2100. Holy shit. Yeah, this could end up really bad. Okay, it's 2100. I don't have this place set up. What I'm actually going to do is just go on top of this shotgun messiah. There we go. That'll get the deal done. And in the morning, what I'll be able to do, because I'm on the shotgun messiah, I'll be able to loot it. Because those guys will, like, beat the hell out of the place. Okay, so let's get this stair here blocked off. I think that's where it comes up. Where does the stair come up again? Okay, cool. And I need to upgrade 3 blocks anyway, so I may as well do that now. 1, 2, 3. There we go. Now they won't be able to get up. They'll be able to, like, bust and kick at it, but they won't be able to get up. Oh, sweet. I can hit that from here. I can't believe I can hit that ladder from here. Holy crap. Must be... Oh, there we go. Okay, so in order to hit it, I gotta kind of aim just a little bit ahead there. Just like that. There we go. I don't want to actually break the block I'm on. So hold it very carefully. Ooh, it's almost 2200 already. So close. I didn't even have a full half an hour to record today's episode because of those mistakes. Okay, cool. Now I'm down here. Now I'm up here. Now I'm safe in the night. So, of course, I'm comfortable with making noise up here because they can't get up here. So what I'm going to do, I think, is use up all the supplies I have. Making stuff, like I'm gonna make, I guess, ooh, wait, no. I'm gonna make a storage, and then start spam crafting stuff, and not leave my torch here this time, because other than that, I only have one candle, which is also in my other storage. Okay, cool. I can put water up in here. You know, everything. Everything can just go up in here. And then I'll take a look at what I can make here. So since we got a few minutes of nighttime, I usually don't show doing this, but since I got a few extra minutes to kill, I'm actually going to scrap that. And I'm saving sham sandwiches as well, too, because like I said in the earlier episode, what I plan on doing is migrating my modded recipe file over from the server onto my single player. Okay, so to make clubs or axes, I'm going to need some wood. I'm going to need stone. And plant fibers? Oh, wow, I actually don't need to, I don't know what I need to make an axe anymore here. I've been at this too long. Okay, yes, plant fibers. There we go. So I can make 59 of these, and what will happen is, as these are making, obviously, it's going to take about 4.5 minutes here. But as they're making, what I do is I just go ahead and scrap them again. Because you get 3 stones back. It takes 5 stones to make one. And you get 3 of those back. So you can actually, after you make these 56, you can probably make 45. And then from there, you can make 35. And then from there, 20. You know what I mean. You guys know what I'm getting at. But yeah, hopefully, and if I do run out of slots, all I do is cancel the building, scrap them all, and then go right back to building again. It's actually super, super easy to do it this way, but I love that you can scrap a stone axe now. Just absolutely adore that fact. Thank you very much, Joel, for doing that. Ooh, 25 hunger. I have nothing to eat either. Ah, that's garbage. So it looks like I won't be moving around too much tonight. Just basically enough to protect. Oh wait, hunger. What am I doing? I'm hungry and I have a fucking stack of these things on me. Okay. Let's eat that. That'll get up my hunger. Wow. Okay. Looks like I'm heating up a bit here too, so I'm gonna have a yucca juice while I'm at it. I should actually, I need to get my health back up to at least 50%, or my hunger, because then I'll start healing again. Wow, these guys are really trashing this place below me. That's freaking awesome. Yeah, guys, keep trashing it. I don't give a shit. It's not my place. There we go. At least get some of my hunger up here. Now, it does take a while. I do love these, though. The yucca fruit's one of my favorite things. Because it gives you stamina back. Like, plus 10 stamina? That's as much as water... how much does water give you? I'm gonna quote myself there. Oh, 20. Or 20, yeah. But, I mean, 10 stamina's not bad. Especially if you're running and you need to keep running. And you're hungry? Bring a stack of these with you. Because... Because you can hold them in your hand and run and eat them. And they keep your stamina up. But at the same time, it's not like you eat one and it fills up 20% of your health, right? So you can eat a bunch of these while running and actually just keep running because of all the stamina they gain and the fact that you gain such a slow rate of hunger back from it, so. Okay, awesome. And that, guys, I think pretty much ends the night here. I'm going to actually cancel that, start scrapping these, make some more room in my inventory here. And I should have better tools when I come back for the next episode. And also my custom heads-up display. So I want to show you guys that as well, too. In the next video, if I remember, on Thursday, remind me, guys. Or on Friday, sorry. If in the next video, I don't put a link to where you can actually find the heads-up display. I found it on the forums. Let me know, and I'll put a link into it. Because the person who made it definitely deserves the recognition. So, as always, guys, I will see you in the next episode. Keep it classy, and remember, always back up your game saves, even if you're on PC, especially on console. And I will see you guys in the next episode. Keep it classy. Have a good one, guys. Peace out. We about to turn it on. Turn it on.